The Injured Senior Podcast is here to help. Like it or not, the senior and elderly population is vulnerable to negligence committed by medical professionals, nursing homes, assisted living facilities, pharmaceutical and medical device companies, insurance companies, and everyday individuals and businesses. Your host, Steve Heisler, creator of the National Injured Senior Law Center, has been advocating for seniors' rights for over 30 years and is bringing you answers to your questions. This is the Injured Senior Podcast.
Good day to all in our injured senior, elderly, and aging population communities. I am Steve Heisler, founder and CEO of the National Injured Senior Law Center, and you are dialed into a brand new episode of the Injured Senior Podcast. For those who are not aware, the Injured Senior Podcast is a show dedicated to discussing medical and legal issues of vital importance to seniors, elderly, and the aging populations, as well as their children, loved ones, and caregivers. We are sponsored by the National Injured Senior Law Center, the legal advocates for aging individuals who've been injured due to the negligence of others. To learn more, go to www.injuredseniorhotline.com. So back about 12, 13 years ago, I got pneumonia. I'm not really sure what caused me to get it, but I definitely caught pneumonia. To be very honest, it scared the living daylights out of me. So I go to the doctor and I am diagnosed with pneumonia. He prescribes antibiotics. I don't like antibiotics, but I went ahead and took the medication because that's what the doctor told me to do. Still, the pneumonia wouldn't go away. It wasn't as severe, but I still had an upper respiratory issue. So I'm trying to figure out how I can get rid of, you know, all the effects of the pneumonia and be back to square one where I started from before I got the pneumonia. So I tried acupuncture, vitamins, but no luck. I just could not shake this upper respiratory problem for the life of me. So I read somewhere that sitting in a dry, hot sauna for short periods of time, like 20, 25 minutes, several days a week, can help with upper respiratory problems. So I found a dry sauna at a local gym and I gave it a try. I can tell you folks that after a couple weeks, I had dramatically improved and was finally done with the pneumonia. I was done. And I was the happiest guy in the world because I felt miserable and I just couldn't function with the pneumonia. So I was so impressed with the positive effects of the sauna that I actually went out and purchased one for myself. Yes, I put a dry sauna in my basement. Now, yeah, you're thinking, oh, okay, how does he get, you know, who can put a dry sauna in the basement? Well, I actually found some Scandinavian individual who went down and built the sauna in my basement. It was a little expensive, but I was so sold on saunas and, you know, just how they cleared up my pneumonia. And I never wanted to get pneumonia again. So I said, I'm going to invest something for my health. I use a sauna 2-3 times a week. And I feel great. So why am I telling you this? Folks, as we age, and I will be 60 next year, our immune system gets weaker and we become much more susceptible to health problems. Yes, the health problems that we talk about on this podcast. There are a lot of health problems that regular sauna use can help prevent, but I want to talk about strokes and the benefit of sauna use. Now, I don't think I have to educate everyone about strokes. We hear about strokes so much, just unfortunately, in our day in and day out lives, but strokes are definitely not a laughing matter. A stroke is the fourth leading cause of death in the United States. Stroke causes more significant long-term disabilities than any other disease, and older people are at higher risk for stroke. There are two types of strokes. One is ischemic stroke. Now, ischemic stroke is caused by a blood clot or blocked artery leading to the brain. This keeps oxygen from getting to brain cells in other parts of the brain and results in a stroke. The second type of stroke is hemorrhagic. A broken blood vessel causes bleeding in the brain, causing horrific results. Consequences of a stroke lead to problems with speaking, thinking, or walking. There's people who have aphasia where they can't talk because of the effects of the stroke. So, you know, stroke is one of the worst things you can have happen to you. According to the NIH, doing the following can reduce your chances of stroke. Control blood pressure, stop smoking, as smoking increases the risk of all types of problems, including heart disease and strokes. Control your cholesterol, control diabetes, eat healthy foods, and exercise regularly. So it's been awesome talking to you today. I hope that this episode was helpful. I look forward to talking to you again real soon next week. Stay well. Bye now.
Thanks for listening to the Injured Senior Podcast. If you enjoyed the podcast, please rate, subscribe, review, and share on Apple, Google, or wherever you get your podcasts. Connect with us at InjuredSeniorPodcast.com and sign up for our newsletter. To find out more or to get help at any time, visit InjuredSeniorPodcast.com or call 855-622-6530. That's 855-622-6530.